Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss about solid state. This chapter now included in your syllabus. Last time in 1920 session it was exempted, not included, right? We know about liquid state, about gaseous state, but here we are going to discuss about solid state also. In class 11th we had discussed about gaseous state. In 12th we studied about solution, in solution chapter about liquid state also, everything we had studied in physics. You had also learned about liquid state, Bernoulli's theorem regarding Pascal's law, right? In this chapter, in this part of this chapter, we are going to discuss about important point of solid state. Under a given set of condition of temperature and pressure, which would be the most stable state? It depends upon the net effect of two opposite factors. One is intermolecular forces, which tend to keep the molecules closer, and another one is thermal energy, which tend to keep them apart by making them move faster. Intermolecular forces and thermal energy. At sufficient low temperature, the thermal energy is low, and intermolecular forces bring them so close that they cling to one another and occupy fixed position. What it means, it doesn't mean they have no thermal energy or no speed. Solid molecules, particles we can say, oscillate about their mean position, and the substance exists in solid state. These can still oscillate about their mean position. Substance exists in solid state . The following are the characteristic properties of solid state. They have definite mass, volume and shape. Intermolecular distances are short. Intermolecular forces are strong. Their constituent particle has fixed position and they can oscillate about their mean position, and they are incompressible. They cannot be compressed. On application of pressure, they cannot change their shape. They cannot change their volume. That's why they are incompressible. They cannot change their volume. They are rigid. They cannot change their shape. Right? That's why they are incompressible. Particles oscillate about their mean position. Intermolecular forces are strong. Intermolecular distances are short. They have definite mass, volume, and shape. The following are the characteristics of These are the characteristics of solid state, right? Now, about crystalline solid. Mainly solids divided or classified into two types. One is crystalline solid, another one is amorphous solid. Crystalline solids usually consist of a large number of small crystals, each of them having a definite characteristic geometrical shape. Properties of crystalline solids: definite characteristic geometrical shape. There is a geometry in crystalline solid. Regarding properties, the arrangement of constituent particle in a crystal is ordered and repeated in three dimensions. Ordered arrangement, a proper arrangement, that is also termed as crystal. It means crystalline solid consists of crystals, and crystals are repeated pattern of arrangement of constituent particle in three dimensions. the same arrangement throughout the crystal, same arrangement throughout the solid. This solid crystal has long range order. Long range order means they have a regular pattern of current, regular pattern of constituent particles in whole crystal, and it repeat periodically. A regular pattern of arrangement of constituent particle which repeat itself periodically over the entire crystal. Sodium chloride and quartz crystals are typical example of crystalline solid. We can see the long range order in this slide. You can see a same arrangement throughout the crystal. Crystalline solid has a sharp melting point. At a point, at a temperature, they fused, melt at a particular temperature. The melting point, freezing point is defined for crystalline solid. Crystalline solids are anisotropic in nature. They are anisotropic. It means the physical properties in crystalline solids are different or differ with direction. Physical properties like electrical resistance, refractive index. Why it happens? Because in crystalline solids there are a clear arrangement. Let in this diagram of crystalline solid, one axis is x axis and another one axis is y axis. What you may find, there is different arrangement in x axis and y axis of constituent particle. It means in different direction the properties might be different. Properties are different, we can say. So crystalline solids are anisotropic in nature. Right, cleavage property. How we cut a crystalline solid? When we cut crystalline solid with sharp edged tool, they split into two pieces and the newly generated surfaces are plain and smooth. Second type of solid are known as amorphous solids. Solid do not form crystal when they are liquid solidified. On cooling are known as amorphous solid. Amorphous means no form. There is no repeated regular pattern of constituent particles. These crystals have no form, no order of pattern of particles. Short range order they follow. Somewhere slight arrangement of particles observed. You can see in this diagram, but overall there's no pattern in whole crystal. These solids soften, melt and start flowing over a range of temperature and can be molded and blown into various shapes. They do not have fixed enthalpy of fusion, as well as we can see, soften, melt and start flowing over a range of temperature. It means there's no sharp fixed melting point. It is very normal phenomena to observe when we use plastic on burning or heating plastic. They soft first, again soften and then melt. Amorphous solids have the same structural feature as liquid and are conveniently regarded as extremely viscous liquid, dense liquid. They may crystalline at some temperature. Some glass objects from ancient civilization are found to become milky in appearance because of some crystallization, like liquid. Amorphous solid have a tendency to flow very slowly. Therefore, sometimes these are called pseudo solid or super cooled liquid. Super cooled liquid, pseudo solid, all are the name given for amorphous solid. Amorphous solids are isotropic in nature as well. Their properties such as mechanical strength, refractive index, and electrical conductivity are same in all direction, isotropic in nature. You can see in this diagram there is no difference in x-axis or y-axis because there is no arrangement at all. Particles are randomly distributed. So overall no significant change observed in physical properties. So that's why they are isotropic in nature. And when we cut with a sharp edge tube, they cut into two pieces with regular surfaces. Some solids which apparently appear amorphous but have microcrystalline structure, these are called polycrystalline solids. Metals often occur in polycrystalline condition. Individual crystals are randomly oriented, so the metallic sample may appear to be isotropic even though a single crystal is an isotope. So this is small point which is given in our book, so I need to mention here. All crystalline solids are classified into four important types: molecular crystal, ionic crystal, network crystal also known as covalent crystal, and metallic crystal. Molecular crystals also classified divided into three types: non-polar molecular crystal, polar molecular crystal, and hydrogen bonded molecular crystal. Molecular solids, number one, or crystal we can say, are constituent particles of molecular solids are molecules. They are further divided into three: non-polar, polar, and hydrogen bonded. Non-polar molecular solids comprise either atom, for example argon, helium, or molecule formed by non-polar covalent bond H2Cl2Br2. In these solids, the atoms or molecule are held by weak dispersion forces or Lagrange forces. These are weakest van der Waals forces. These solids are soft and non-conductor of electricity, and they have low melting point. They are usually liquid or gaseous state at room temperature and pressure. Polar molecular solid, the molecules of substance like HCl, SO2, etc. are formed by polar covalent bond. Again, but here because they are polar, so stronger dipole-dipole interaction is there. These solids are soft and again non-conductor of electricity, insulator are they. Melting points are higher than those of non-polar. Most of these are gases, SO2, NH3. Hydrogen bonded molecular solids, molecules of such solids contain polar covalent bonds between H and FON atoms. Strong hydrogen bonding binds molecules of such solids like H2. They are non-conductor of electricity. Generally, they are volatile liquid or soft solid under room temperature and pressure. Ionic solids are constituent particles. Again, is ions, ionic solid ions, molecular solid molecules. Cation anions involve in that 3D geometry of solid crystals. They are hard and brittle in nature. High melting and boiling point. They are conductor in solid state. They are insulator, sorry. They are insulator in solid state. But when dissolved in water, they becomes conductor. In molten state also they are conductor. The reason of conductivity in molten and solution is the movement of free ion. It means charge carrier in ionic solids are free ions. Metallic solids are orderly collection of positive ions surrounded by and held together by a sea of free electrons. This is electron sea models for metals. Electrons are mobile and evenly spread out throughout the crystal. Each metal atom contributes one or more electrons toward the sea of mobile electrons. These free and mobile electrons are responsible for high electrical and thermal conductivity of metal. When electric field is applied, these electrons flow through the network of positive ions. And when heat is supplied, again the same thing will happen. Flow from one end to another end. High conductivity, that's why this is so high conductivity. Another important characteristics of metal is their luster and color in certain cases. This is also due to the presence of free electron in them. Metals are highly malleable and ductile as well. Covalent and solid or network solid. A wide variety of crystalline solid of non-metals result from the formation of covalent bond between adjacent atoms throughout the crystal, also called giant molecules. Covalent bonds are strong and directional in nature, therefore atoms are held strongly at their position. Such solids are very hard and brittle. They have extremely high melting point and may even decompose before melting. They are insulated and do not conduct electricity. Diamond and silicon carbide are typical example of such solid. Graphite is also an example of covalent solid, but it is good conductor of electricity and relatively soft. Graphite molecules, in this graph we can say, in graphite molecules, atoms arranged in layers, hexagonal layers, and all hexagonal layers were attracted with each other by van der Waals force of attraction. Each atom bonded with three different atoms. It means there is one free electron per atom in this crystal. This electron may diffuse in the same layer and conduct electricity. Other diamond, which is each carbon atom show tetrahedral arrangement, and silicon dioxide, which we know as silicates, sand is important compound of silicate. Silicon carbide is also very important, very hard substance it is, and graphite. These are some examples of crystalline solids that are covalent solids. There are differences in these different solids and very important for examination point of view. You need to remember these differences, these important points related with solids. So in this part, what we discussed, first we discussed about the solid state. The first classification of solid state is crystalline solid and amorphous solid. And again, then we classify crystalline solids into these. Here, these are differences between crystalline solids and amorphous solids are important from examination point of view also. Right. So read this chapter, read this part of this chapter. We'll discuss latter part of this chapter in next class. Thank you for today.